आय एम मिस्टर पी पी मित्रगोत्री, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग ॲट वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी व्हॉट इज मर्चंट सर्कल, व्हॉट इज मर्चंट सर्कल डायग्रॅम अँड हाऊ इट कॅन बी युटिलाइज्ड फॉर ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ फोर्सेस ॲक्टिंग अलॉंग शिअर प्लेन अँड ॲक्टिंग अलॉंग टूल चिप इंटरफेस ड्युरिंग मेटल कटिंग प्रोसेस अँड हाऊ वी आर एबल टू ग्राफिकली कॅल्क्युलेट मॅग्नेट्यूड ऑफ शिअर फोर्स नॉर्मल टू शिअर फोर्स, मॅग्नेट्यूड ऑफ टूल फोर्स अँड नॉर्मल टू द टूल फोर्स विथ द हेल्प ऑफ धीस डायग्रॅम. And outcome of this particular session will be learners will be able to draw merchant circle diagram and will be able to calculate various forces acting along shear plane as well as along tool chip interface by orthogonal cutting, and this is graphical method of representing the forces. Now for drawing this diagram and for further things, first and basic assumption is our metal cutting is orthogonal cutting. Orthogonal cutting is a two-dimensional cutting. It is strictly confined to two dimensions. Now for drawing merchant circle diagram, required data is we have to measure cutting force denoted by letter FC, which acts in the direction of tool travel or tool feed, and thrust force denoted by letter FT, which acts perpendicular to the cutting force. These two forces are measured by tool dynamometer during metal cutting operation. Rake angle of the cutting tool is denoted by letter alpha, is recorded from specification of the cutting tool that we are employing for orthogonal turning or orthogonal cutting. And uncut chip thickness denoted by letter T and chip thickness after cut denoted by letter C are to be recorded. Now we will begin the procedure for construction of merchant circle diagram. Now first of all, we have to draw a vertical line parallel to y-axis, and we have to draw a tool face making an angle alpha, that is rake angle, with the vertical line. After that, we have to draw a cutting force FC, which is measured by lead tool dynamometer acting in the direction of tool travel with proper scale of correct magnitude as shown in the diagram. Then we have to draw a thrust force perpendicular to the cutting force with the same scale and with proper magnitude. Then we have to draw the resultant of these two forces. This resultant cutting force and thrust force will form a triangle. Now next important thing is we have to carry out geometrical construction, which we have studied in school days, to find out midpoint of the resultant, because this midpoint is going to act as a center of the circle which we are going to draw through these three points of the triangle, and that is called as merchant circle. This merchant circle is visible in the diagram now. Along with merchant circle, we are observing cutting force and thrust force. Then next construction will be, we have to show uncut chip thickness with proper scale, and as uncut chip thickness is measured along the direction of tool travel, line representing uncut chip thickness will be parallel to the cutting force as shown in the diagram. Then chip will always flow along the tool face, so cut chip thickness will be parallel to the tool face, and cut chip thickness is denoted by letter TC. Now these two lines intersect somewhere, and that point of intersection is visible in the diagram. Now through that point of intersection and through the tool point, we have to draw the line cutting the circle at certain point. This line represents the shear force denoted by letter Fs, and you have to understand the angle made by this line with cutting force. I think you can understand it. This is reflection spot in our video. I will wait for a moment. I understand that you have followed it, and this angle can be no other than shear angle denoted by letter phi. Now we have to draw the line perpendicular to the shear force, which will join the resultant force, and this shear normal to the shear force is denoted by letter Fn, and resultant top shear force and normal to the shear force is also the resultant top cutting force and thrust force that we can very well understand from this diagram. We have constructed shear force and normal to the shear force. We have to measure their magnitude and this magnitude with proper scale, and we have to transform them into newtons or kgs as per the scale that we have adopted. And angle between cutting force and shear force we can measure, and we can say that this is the shear angle. Then we have to draw a tool force along the line of the tool face from the tool point, and that will cut the circle at point shown in the diagram. This tool force is denoted by letter F. Then we have to draw a perpendicular line joining the resultant, which will represent normal to the tool force, which is denoted by letter N. We have to measure the magnitude of F and N, and these magnitudes, if transformed into proper scale, they will give us the number, that is the value of newtons. And this way we can graphically represent and graphically calculate all the forces. Now I will once again rapidly repeat the procedure that we have followed. What we require? We require to know cutting force and thrust force. We have to draw cutting force, thrust force and resultant triangle. Then we have to find out the midpoint of the resultant by geometrical construction. With that midpoint as a center, we have to draw, and resultant as a radius, we have to draw the circle which represent merchant, which is called as merchant circle. Then we have to draw a line representing uncut chip thickness parallel to the cutting force, and we have to draw the line representing chip thickness after cut parallel to the tool face, and through the point of intersection of these two lines and through the tool point, we have to draw the line cutting the circle which will represent shear force, and we have to draw the line perpendicular to that which will represent normal to the shear force, and angle between shear force line and cutting force line is none other than shear angle. Similarly, line along the tool face will be tool force, and perpendicular to that will be representing normal to the tool force. Hope you have understood the procedure to draw the merchant circle and procedure for calculating various forces acting along the shear plane and chip tool interface by merchant circle diagram. For further reading, I will recommend a book by Machine Tool Engineering by J.R. Nagpal, and Textbook of Production Engineering by P.C. Sharma. Thank you.